right, in this demonstration, we'll finalize the report layout of the sales performance report. Specifically, I'm going to add in some drill-down capabilities from country to salesperson and to enable interactive sort on the sales column. Returning to the report design, the focus now is on the grouping pane. I left it in advanced mode. Let me switch that back to standard mode. And what I'll do is right-click the details group and open the group properties and then open up the visibility page. By default, I want the salespeople hidden, so I'll hide this group. And then I'm going to enable the toggle and then select the country group. Let's preview the report and see the result. Okay, now that's in print layout, which is not a render format that's going to work for this interactivity. So turning print layout off, now we see we're in HTML, and we have this ability to expand or collapse within the countries.
Exactly.
Second feature is to enable interactive sort on the sales column. So that's achieved by configuring the properties of the text box in a header or a group header. So here for the table header, I right-click, open up the text box properties for the sales. There's the interactive sorting page. I enable it, and I'm going to achieve sorting at the country group level. The expression then will be, by the way, not the country field. It must be the sum of the sales value. So at country grouping level, what is the sum of sales, and then sort in either ascending or descending order of it. Let's see how this works. All right, so default order is actually sorting alphabetically by the look of it.
Yep.
And yet we notice that on the column header for sales, we can see a sort control. Clicking it once, sorts ascending. Clicking a second time, descending. All right, so I think we've pretty much finished the design of this report. The way that I wrap up the design is, before you publish it, remove any unnecessary space. Notice here that at design time, people wonder why when they print, and it's quite annoying because it only happens sometimes.
Yes.
All right, so always make sure I will remove absolutely everything. If I do want a gap between my footer content, then I put that in the footer itself.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and remember to double check that the width of the body hasn't exceeded. So here's a good trick. If you click, for example, any text box here, and you press the escape key, you're going to move up the hierarchy of objects. So from text box to tablex to the body itself. All right, the body isn't visible because it's completely obscured by the tablex. But here we can verify that the width is still the 7.5 inches.
Nice.
All right, so I think now the report design is done. I'm going to save it locally. And we're going to go ahead and publish this to the Power BI service.
It looks great.
It's going to look even better when we get to render it in the Power BI service. So we've got the sales performance report. We save. Switch across to our reports. Thank you. And here we go. Rendered in the service. For fiscal year 2019, here are our countries. Sortable. I like that control. It's very nice.
Thank you.
Descending, and the ability then to expand within to see the individual salespeople. Beautiful. All right, we'll return to this when we start to explore the consumption experience in a later presentation. There you go, interactive features added to our sales performance report.